Outstanding. Have a big applause because you are doing it. Probability. Mind blowing topic because you have to read it in further classes also.
First of all, we should know that what is probability. Probability means the chance of happening an event. When expressed in terms of numerical or expressed quantitatively, is called as probability.
Outstanding.
Further, we see that probability, the theory of the probability was given by an Italian mathematician, Jerome Cardan.
Outstanding. Jerome Cardan has given the
He gave the theory of probability, and further many other mathematicians they contributed this theory of probability completely.
Good.
And further, this probability it is divided into subtopics, that is experimental probability and theoretical probability.
Outstanding.
These are the two subtopics of this probability. First of all, we should know that what is experimental and theoretical probability. If we see that these are the two subtopics of probability, means they are both are based on their chance of happening an event.
Good.
But the main difference between the experimental and theoretical probability is that this theoretical probability, it attempts to predict, means that what will happen.
So it is based on the future.
It predicts what will happen when an experiment is done. And the experimental probability is the chance of happening an event. It is also a subtopic of this probability. And it attempts that what has happened, that when an experiment is done and what is the outcome, that what has happened. It is of present.
Outstanding.
There are so many. We will take this experimental probability. Further, we see this. First, we will see random experiment.
Good. Random experiment.
We will first see that what is random experiment. Random experiment and experiment is done. If we do an experiment in an identical condition and the outcomes produced, that will be different. First of all, I will say that what is outcome. Outcome, it is the possible result when an experiment is done. For example, if we take a simple example that you all will be aware. If we take an example of hydrogen plus oxygen, H plus O, it will give H2O. It's unbalanced, further we make it balanced. Here, these are the two substances that form. It is on the case of experiment. We have first experienced it, that the result produced, we see it as outcome.
Good.
But if we see in random experiment, if we do an experiment and it produces different outcomes. For example, if we roll a die, what will be the there? Its sample space will be 1, 2, 3. Here we get different outcomes. If we see, we will. If we roll a die, we will get. Various events. Further, I will say that what are the sample space events. First, we will get, if we see a roll a die, we will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In first setup, if we roll a die, we will get an event that is 1. And this next time, we will, it is a probability, we will get another number or something else. Then it is called as means we will get different outcomes.
Good.
But what can we say that if we have an experiment, we are doing this experiment in an identical condition, but we are getting the same outcome every time. Then that time we call that very experiment as deterministic experiment.
Outstanding.
Extreme, for example, experiment. We say that suppose we take a coin. Coin, you know, we take a coin. If we toss a coin, we know that it has a head and tail. But if we take a coin that has both sides of tail, then that very time we will get at all the time we will toss a coin, we will get tail, because it has a coin has both sides of tail. If we do 100 times this experiment, we toss a coin having both sides of tail, we will all times we will get same result, that is tail, because it has both. So that time we will call it a deterministic experiment.
Outstanding, good. Confine your words now in just 1 minute. Simply get the definition of sample space and this event. Give the rest.
Sample space. It means it is a set of all the possible outcomes. If we take two coins, we will toss two coins simultaneously. If we toss two coins, we will get a sample space, means the set of all the possible
outcomes. Good.
We will get head, tail, head, and tail. It's called the sample space when we toss two coins simultaneously. Good. And further, there is event. Event, we say that it is a subset of the sample space. If we have, take this example, if we have, it is a sample space. If we say that event is a subset of sample space, we can write it as, if we take an event A, it will be equal to head, or head, tail. It becomes a subset of the sample
space. Good, better, good.